Hello students and welcome to this new video. My name is Mrinal Pandey and today we are going to start the revision of your three chapters. Okay, today we will take up the first chapter which we have studied up till now. As you all of you have must have studied, we have completed three chapters of your syllabus. Okay, the first, second and third chapters have been completed and now what we are going to do, we are going to start the revision of these chapters. Today we will take up the first chapter. Your first chapter was parts of a computer. This chapter we all of you have already studied, ma'am had taught all of you. Now what I'm going to do, I am going to revise this chapter with all of you. I will explain this chapter in a brief manner to all of you. If you have any queries, you can ask the questions in the WhatsApp, either in the WhatsApp group or in the, you can't ask the questions in the WhatsApp group, but you can ask your questions in the, you can post your queries in the Google Classroom and I will try to solve your problems. Okay, this video is only for revision. You have already studied this chapter and today I am going to explain this chapter again to you to revise this chapter with you all. So let us start this chapter, all of us. See, first of all, we should understand what is computer. Okay, what is a computer? All of us know computer is an amazing machine that can do different types of work. We can perform different types of work by using a computer. We can play games. We can write letters, we can draw pictures, we can listen to music. See, this much all of us know that a computer is a machine which is capable of doing a lot of things. Okay, we can listen to music also, we can check spellings, we can make documents, store information, calculations, many things we can do with the help of a computer. Okay, in the previous class we have learned the use of computers in different fields. Okay, what different fields were there? Like space research, all of us know that in space research also computers are used. Space research means what? When we are studying about space, okay, the different objects in space, different planets, different stars, different asteroids in space, all these studies in all the different space research projects, computer is being used. Then in offices, in hospitals, in designing many different things, in banks, in animated movies, in airports, defense, all these are different sectors, different fields where computers are being used today. Okay, so a computer is one of the greatest inventions, all of us know that. Now we come on to the main types of instructions which a computer can process, the main functions which a computer can perform. What functions a computer can perform? It works at a very high speed and it performs the following functions. Okay, what are the functions of a computer? First of all, input means what? It can accept the data which is given by any user. Second thing is processing means what? It can work on the data, whatever data we have supplied, whatever instructions we have given, depending on the instructions what it will do, it can work on the data, it can process the data. Okay, like for example, if we are inputting two values, we are inputting two numbers into the computer and we want to add these two numbers, we want the computer to add these two numbers and the computer should give us the sum of these two numbers. So what it can do, it can also add these two numbers by using the instruction into the computer. Then third thing is output. Output means giving the desired results. It will give us the desired results. Then fourth thing is storage. It will store the information according to our need. Okay, I think this much is clear to all of you. Now we come on to the functions of a computer in detail. Just now we had just got an introduction of the functions. Now we will study all of these functions in detail. First of all, what is input? The data and the instructions. What are input? The data and the instructions which we enter using a keyboard or a mouse are known as input. Okay, we can enter numbers, words, pictures or sounds as an input. Then second thing is processing. After entering the data and instructions in a computer, the CPU works on the input to give a meaningful information. Okay, this is called processing. Processing means what? After we have entered the data instructions, depending on the instructions, by making use of the instructions, by following the instructions, the CPU means what? The central processing unit or the processor. The processor will work on the instructions. It will work on the input by following the instructions and by working on the input, it will do the processing to create a meaningful information. So it will give a meaningful information by processing the data. Okay, this is known as processing. Now, third thing is output. When the data is processed in the CPU to give useful information, it is known as output. Okay, this input-output process IPO cycle can be understood with the help of an example. Here they have given an example. What example is given? Suppose we want to calculate the total marks of different subjects on a computer. Okay, if you want to calculate total marks, what is there? First of all, we have to provide the input. What is the input in this case? The input is the total marks of different subjects like physics, Hindi, English, Math, Science. Okay, we are studying different subjects. Computer is a subject. So what we are doing? We are entering the total marks of different subjects, and we want to calculate the total marks. Means what? That we are entering the marks of different subjects, and we want to add and we want to calculate the total marks of different subjects by adding these different marks. Okay, here 90, 85, 69, 98, 76, 84. These are different marks. Okay, operating different subjects, and by using the computer, what we will do? We want to calculate the sum of these numbers. So how it can be done? First of all, the first step is to input the data instructions. That is the marks and the plus symbol. Plus symbol will tell us why we are inputting the plus symbol here. We are inputting the plus symbol to tell the computer that we want to add these two numbers. Okay, this plus symbol will tell the computer that we want to add these. We want to add these different marks. Okay, then what is the second step? Is the processing. What will happen in processing? All these different marks will be added together. Okay, it means working on the data on the basis of given instruction. What was the instruction? The instruction was a plus symbol. Okay, and what are the data? The data was the different numbers. And then what is the output here? The output will be the sum of these marks in different subjects. Okay, this is the meaningful information. So this number is the meaningful information or the result. Okay, it has some meaning. Okay, it is not necessary that data will have some meaning, but information will always have some meaning. After processing, the data will always carry some meaning. This is the meaning of output. Okay, now on the basis of the total marks obtained, the teacher can calculate the percentage of a student and finds his or her position in the class. Okay, so on the basis of the total marks obtained, we can see that the teacher will calculate the percentage of a student and finds his or her position in the class also. Okay, likewise, we can also perform many other tasks also by following the IPA or the input process output cycle. Okay, we will now see many day-to-day life examples of the input process output cycle. Okay, like for example, everybody's mother at home is preparing cup tea for us. Okay, everybody knows that mother always every day prepares tea for us in at home. But what are the steps that a mother takes while preparing the tea? Like every other task, preparing the tea is also a task which is having different steps. So what are those steps which our mother takes every day for preparing the cup of tea? See, the first step here in the case is gathering the ingredients or gathering the items which are required for making the tea. What are these items? These different items are like water, tea leaves, milk and sugar. These items are the ingredients which are used for making the tea. All of us know that. So this first step is the input step is the gathering of the ingredients. Okay. Now second step is using these ingredients to make the tea. It is known as the process. Here what is the meaning of process here? Processing means working on the ingredients to prepare the tea. What is the process actually here? The process here is boiling water, then adding tea leaves to the boiling water, then adding milk and then adding sugar. Okay, then after these things are boiled together, the tea will be prepared by using this process. So here this process is the making of the tea here, which is the second step. Then what is the third step? After tea has been made in the processing, the third step is the output. Here what is the output of this process? The tea making process output is the prepared tea. Now our mother will pour the tea into the cup and she will serve the tea to all of us. Okay, this is the prepared tea. This is the output. So this is also an example of a input process output cycle in our day-to-day life. Okay, like in the case of computers, here also in our daily lives also we are following this IPO cycle. Okay, now let us take another example. What do you do when you want to talk to your friend on a telephone? Okay, when you want to talk to our friend on a telephone, then what we do? First of all, what we'll do? We will dial the number. Okay, so dialing the number is the type of input here. Okay, inputting means what? Dialing the number. Like what? How do we input anything into the computer? We type that thing into the keyboard. Similarly, what we can do? We can enter the input into the keyboard. We can dial the number, and that dialing the number will be treated as the input. So here input means what? Dialing the number. Similarly, what will the process? The process here will be connecting the number. connecting the number means what? Your mobile, whenever you dial the number in the mobile, what does the mobile do? The mobile phone will connect your number to the person whose number you are dialing. Okay. So making the connection is a type of process. Here, what is the process? Process is connecting the number which has been dialed. Okay. The third is, what is the output of the process? That now the connection has been established. Now the number has been dialed. The person has received the phone. After the person has received the phone, you can talk to your friend. What is the output here? That after dialing the number and the connection has been made in the processing, and now in the output you can talk to your friend who has now picked up the phone, and now the connection has been made, and now you are able to talk to your friend. So this is another example of the input output process output or the IPO cycle. Here, what is the input? Dialing the number. Processing was connecting to the number or making the connection to the number, to the person to whom you are calling, and the output is talking to that person after the connection has been made. Okay, now we come on to the next topic, which is the parts of a computer. So a computer, all of us, we have already studied this. What are the parts of a computer? A computer has four main parts, okay, which help us in performing the IPO cycle. See, what is the main motive of these four parts? It has to perform the IPO cycle, input process output. In every task, computer is following the same cycle. First of all, we will provide some input, which will be data and instructions. Data as well as instructions we will input into the computer. Then second, in the second step of the IPO cycle, it will do the processing, and in the third step it will display the output to us after the processing has been done. Okay, so every task which the computer is performing is following the IPO cycle. Every single task, whether it is making a document, whether it is watching a movie, whether it is playing a game, every task which you perform will follow the same IPO cycle. Okay, input, process, and output. So what are the parts of a computer? The first part is the keyboard. Okay, a keyboard is the most important part of the computer. It has a number of keys on it. Okay, we enter the information and instructions into the computer by using the keyboard. The second part is the monitor. A monitor looks like a TV screen. It displays the work that we do on a computer. It also displays the results and movement of the mouse pointer on the screen. Whatever operation we are performing on the computer, that operation can be monitored on the screen. Okay, the monitor names comes from the job which it is doing. It is actually used for monitoring. Monitoring means what? For displaying, for seeing some activity, for seeing some operation which is being performed. Okay, for displaying the work that we do on the computer, the monitor or the screen is used. A monitor looks like a TV screen. All of us have seen TV screen in our homes. The monitor is exactly similar to a TV screen. Okay, it is used for displaying the work that we do on a computer. It also displays the results and the movement of the mouse pointer on the screen. The mouse pointer is also displayed on the screen. A monitor is also known as VDU. What does the video? VDU stands for? VDU stands for Visual Display Unit. Okay. The information that we see on a monitor is called soft copy. There are three types of monitors. Three types of monitors are CRT, which is a cathode ray tube monitor. It is an old type of monitor. Cathode ray tube monitors are not coming in today. They are not being used in today. They are not much being used. Okay. Today, what is being used much? It is the LCD and the LED monitors. Okay. CRT monitors are old monitors. They are still being used somewhere, but mostly they have been replaced by the LCD and the LED monitors. CRT monitors are bigger in size and consume more power. Okay, they are using more power, they are using more electricity, and they are bigger in size. Second one is the LCD monitor. LCD monitor had came after CRT monitors. Okay, LCD stands for liquid crystal display monitor. Okay, what is the type of monitor? It is a flat type of computer screen. It is a flat type of computer screen that consumes less power. Okay, it consumes less power than the CRT monitor. And it is in maximum use today. Okay, maximum systems are today using the LCD monitor. Okay, then the latest is the LED monitor. Okay, LED stands for the light emitting diode. Today many TVs are also LED. Many people are today using the LED TVs. Okay, the LED monitors are also very similar to the LED TVs which we are using in our homes. Okay, what are these LED monitors? These monitors have better display than the LCD and the CRT monitors. Okay. They are thinner and they are lighter in weight. They are thinner and lighter in weight as compared to LCD as well as the CRT monitors. They use 40% less power than the LCDs and last longer. okay? Then the CPU or the central processing unit. It is the brain of a computer. CPU means what? Central processing unit. The unit which is doing the processing. What is the CPU? It is the brain of a computer that controls all the functions of a computer. It does all calculations and displays the result on the monitor. It also stores a lot of information. Okay, so this is the function of a computer. It controls all the functions of a computer. Okay, a CPU is made up of three main parts. What are these three main parts? They are memory unit, control unit, and the ALU, or the arithmetic and logical unit. What is the memory unit? In this unit, we can store the information or data according to our need. The information in the memory can be changed and recalled on the screen when needed. Okay, the memory unit is used for storing the information. Okay, the information in the memory can also be changed as per our wish. If you want to change the information, we can change it also. It can be recalled. Recalled means what? Whenever we want to see the information again, after saving it, the next time whenever we want to see the information again, we can every time we can recall. Recalling means what? We can again see the information which we had saved previously. The previously saved information can again be seen, again be recalled, again be displayed on the monitor as per our wish. Whenever we want, whenever we need, we can display the information which was saved previously in the system. The data and the instructions are also stored in the memory unit, which are to be processed. Whatever data instructions are to be processed, they are always stored in the memory unit. Okay, now we come on to the CPU or the control unit. The control unit works like a traffic policeman. Okay, what is the work of a traffic policeman? A traffic policeman controls the traffic. Similarly, control unit is also controlling the data transfer between different units of the CPU. Okay, the control unit is transferring the data instruction transfer between different units of the central processing unit. Okay, it is used for controlling, it controls and manages the working of all the parts of a computer, not only the CPU. All the different parts of a computer are managed and controlled by using the control unit. Okay. Now we come out of the ALU or the arithmetic and the logical unit. What is the work of this ALU? This unit is used for performing all the arithmetic calculations. Whatever arithmetic calculations we are performing, whether it is addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, all types of calculations are done by the ALU or the arithmetic and logical unit. Like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. It also performs logical operations like finding the greater number, smaller number, greater than equal to, less than equal to, or equal to and not equal to numbers. Okay, all these different operations can be performed by the ALU. Now we come out to the mouse. What is a mouse? All of us must have seen the mouse. Okay, what is a mouse? A mouse is a type of pointing device. Okay, it is used for pointing to any icon or object on the computer screen, on the monitor. It is connected to the CPU by a cable. Okay, although today we have wireless mouses also. Okay, we have two types of mouses. We have two types of mice. One is a wireless mouse. A wireless mouse doesn't have a cable, and one is a wired mouse. A wired mouse has a cable. It is connected to the CPU by a using a cable. Okay, a mouse usually has two buttons on it. Okay, it has two buttons. One is the left button and one is the right button. It is used to point, select and move any object on the screen. Okay, when we move a mouse with our hand, a pointer on the screen moves in the same direction. Okay, whenever we move the mouse with our hand, a pointer, which is the cursor, will always move on the screen in the same direction. It is not the cursor, but it is the mouse pointer. Okay, whenever we move the mouse, a pointer on the screen will always move in the same direction. Okay, it also helps to draw pictures. Okay, it also helps if you have used paint before, you must have seen in your lab also that we can also draw a lot of pictures in MS Paint. If you have used paint, you must have seen this, that a mouse also helps us to draw pictures. By dragging the mouse, by choosing some color or some line tool, we can draw pictures, we can color those pictures, we can draw sceneries, we can draw a lot of pictures with the help of a mouse in paint and other softwares. Okay, nowadays mostly the scroll mouse is in use, which has a wheel in the center of the two buttons. Okay, a scroll mouse is being used which has a scroll wheel in between two buttons. This scroll wheel is used for scrolling the documents which we are viewing. Okay, now Now we come on to the printer. What is a printer? A printer prints information from a computer onto a paper. Okay. Whenever you want to get a printout, what is a printout? A printout is a hard copy of the document. Okay. A printer is used for obtaining the hard copy of the document. A printer is used for printing the information on a piece of paper from the computer. Whatever information is stored on the computer, that can be printed on a piece of paper by using a printer. So printer is also a type of output object like a computer screen. Okay. The output printed on a paper is called a hard copy. Okay. The output can be either in black and white or in color depending on the printer type. If a printer is black and white printer, it will print you a black and white printout or a black and white hard copy. If the printer is a colored printer, then you can also get a colored printout from the printer. Now, what makes a computer powerful? Okay, what are the features of a computer which makes it powerful? First of all, it is the speed. A computer works very fast and can do a large number of calculations very quickly. Okay, this is the first feature. Then reliability. Computers are quite reliable. They do not make any mistakes. Okay. Then third one is storage. Reliability, I have understood that they can't make any mistakes. So we can rely on the computer. We can trust on the computer. Okay. Third one is storage. A computer can store a large amount of data which can be used anytime. Okay. We can store a large amount of data and we can use it anytime that we want. Versatility. Versatility means ability to perform different types of tasks. Ability to perform a variety of tasks of different type. A computer can perform a variety of tasks and is used in almost all fields. In all fields of life today, we are using computers. This is the meaning of versatility. Accuracy. Accuracy means what? A computer always gives correct results. A computer never gives you a wrong result. Okay. Mistakes are normally done from a user side. Whatever mistakes a computer makes, that are only because of either the computer program is having some mistake, it is having some fault, or some error is there in the computer program, or the user which is using the program, he or she has made some mistakes. Some mistakes are normally done from the user side. Mistakes never occur from the computer side. Computer never makes any mistake on its own. Okay, whatever mistake is there, that is in the instructions which are given to the computer. The mistake or error could be in the program which is being used on the computer, but the computer will never make a mistake on its own. Diligence. Diligence means hard working. A computer can work for long hours without getting tired. If we work for long hours, we will always get tired, but a computer never gets tired and it can work for long hours without getting tired. Then multitasking. Multitasking means what? A computer is capable of performing a number of tasks simultaneously at a single time. Okay, a computer can do many tasks at the same time. Okay, at the same time, computer can do many tasks together. This is known as multitasking. Okay, now we come on to the disadvantages of a computer. What are the disadvantages? A computer is a useful learning tool, but the disadvantages are as follows. First of all, it has zero IQ. Zero IQ means what? IQ means intelligence quotient. Intelligence quotient means what? The ability of a person to work on, the ability of a person to work on her his or her own. Okay, if a person has a very good intelligence quotient or a good IQ, then that person will be able to decide and do any work on its own. Okay, that person will have the ability to think and do something on his or her own. But a computer is having zero IQ. It means that a computer cannot decide or do anything on its own. A computer does not have any thinking ability. Okay, a computer does not have an IQ on its own. It has no intelligence. By mistake, if you enter the incorrect input, it will give you the wrong result. Okay, whatever input and whatever instructions we do, it will blindly follow those instructions. It will work on the input. If you give it wrong instructions or if you give it wrong input, incorrect input, then it will also give us the wrong result also. Okay, now one good, very good health tip is also given over here. Working on a computer for long hours could affect your eyesight. Your eyesight will become weak if you work for a long time. It could also become the cause of obesity. Obesity means people become fat. If they're sitting and working on a long time on a computer or on a laptop, they always become fat. There's always a chance of becoming fat. Okay. So one should avoid working on the computer continuously for a long time. Now, one more disadvantage is that electricity. A computer depends on electricity and cannot work for a long time without electricity. Okay. Then it is very, very costly also. It is a costly device and people who are not having good money, they will not be able to afford to buy a computer. ओनली दोज पीपल विच आर हु आर हैविंग अ गुड अमाउंट ऑफ मनी और नॉट गुड नॉट अ गुड अमाउंट ऑफ मनी बट अ फेयर अमाउंट ऑफ मनी ओनली दोज पीपल विल एबल टू अफोर्ड अ कंप्यूटर. कंप्यूटर्स कांट बी अफोर्डेड बाई एवरीबडी. ओके दे आर स्टिल कॉस्टली. ओके सो दिस नाउ विथ नाउ दिस विथ दिस वी हैव कंप्लीटेड दिस चैप्टर. आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू गो थ्रू दिस चैप्टर. ओके इफ यू हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम यू कैन आस्क इन द गूगल क्लास रूम. ओके यू कैन पोस्ट योर क्वेरीज ओवर देयर. आई विल ट्राई टू सॉल्व योर प्रॉब्लम्स. ओके आई होप दिस चैप्टर वॉज क्लियर टू यू. इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी विल रिवाइज द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर विच इज चैप्टर नंबर 2. टिल देन थैंक यू.